is a wonderful event that takes place annually here in the Santa Clarita Valley. In fact, this particular event, the 51st Annual Premier Volunteer Recognition Event, the 2016 Santa Clarita Valley Man and Woman of the Year. This dinner is being held 6 p.m. Friday, May 6th at the Hyatt Valencia. And the purpose of this is to recognize and honor men and women who've given outstanding volunteer service to the Santa Clarita Valley area. Now, for me, this is a tremendous honor to get the opportunity to speak to the fine men and women in our valley who have given so much, who do so much. What's that thing they say? You want something done, ask a busy person. In front of me right now, I have two of the busiest people in the Santa Clarita Valley, and I'm going to talk with them all about their nominations for the SCV Man and Woman of the Year. We're going to start with Dennis Koontz. Sir, hello and welcome.
Hi, how are you?
I am fine. I'm going to talk to you first because I understand you were nominated by the SCV 4th of July Parade Committee, and I love that the very first paragraph that they say about you is that you are mild-mannered, but you have a can-do attitude and is a hard worker behind the scenes. I've had the great honor and pleasure of actually seeing you behind those scenes. You are a very busy man. You retired from the Los Angeles City Fire Department as fire captain, which meant you worked really hard when you were there. Did you just decide, I have to continue to work hard, and so I'm going to do this on behalf of our city? How'd you get involved in all the volunteer work that you do here in Santa Clarita?
Well, I've actually been involved in the community when I was a young boy. My mother and father were very, very much involved in the community, scouting. And so as soon as I moved here, and that was in 1971, started participating then in Boy Scouts and also helping out at schools. And I did
Yes. But you've been busy since you were
at Rosedale School.
Okay.
And they were working with computers, and so I offered to teach some computer skills, and that was not as a teacher and, you know, credentialed, but I taught them what I knew.
Volunteering again.
Volunteering. Yes. Now, that voice you hear is his wife, Linda, who he married in 1990, and you also nominated by the SCV 4th of July Parade Committee. Within the studio with us also, we have Linda Storley. Now, you were nominated. How did you come? Because I know you're very busy. You're an educator. I can throw my daughter under the bus and say you were one of her very favorite teachers, so I have personal experience having heard stories about you. But you, in addition to doing that, how did you come to being that busy person who said, okay, I'm not just done at the end of the day and grading papers until my eyes are bloodshot red. I'm going to help in the community too. How did that come about for you?
I became very involved when I was in college, and I became involved in politics. I was appointed to a presidential commission, and I guess that's kind of where it started. When I moved to Santa Clarita, we weren't a city yet. I became involved in the city formation committee, where I met my husband here, ran for city council. He won. He forgot to say that he was an Eagle Scout. That's one of his biggest accomplishments, I think.
It really is. It really is. You know, at that age,
it's amazing.
The idea that there are so many other distractions that you get on that path and you go right on through to Eagle Scout, that is a tremendous, tremendous level of loyalty and stick-to-itiveness that follows you all the days of your life. So thank you for bringing that up.
And I think that that's one of his. We worked together on the formation committee, ran for city council against each other. The fireman won, and
did that make for interesting breakfast, by the way?
Oh, yes, it certainly did. Then we got involved in doing Mr. and Mrs. Santa Claus for various charities, and kind of fell into the 4th of July parade just because I love 4th of July parades, and my mentor was Connie Warden Roberts, and she's a tough act to follow, but kind of slipped into her place As time went on, and then been running the parade for the last 10 years.
Now, we do have one of the best 4th of July parades. It is. If you've never been to the Santa Clarita 4th of July event, this parade is, it's everything you've ever thought of in a Norman Rockwell painting. It's everything you've ever thought of, true Americana, the things that people, you'll see it in a film, you'll see it in, you'll hear it in a story. It's here in our own town, and it's a remarkable event to see roll through our streets. And you both work tirelessly to help make that happen. Are you looking for volunteers, by the way?
Yes.
Always looking for volunteers. I found out last night we have 3,500 people that are in the parade. We have 25,000 people that watch the parade.
It's a remarkable event.
And it's like from about February on, even though I was just elected to the school board, I have a couple of other duties there. But from about February on, we need to start meeting. And you have been a delightful addition to our announcers. And KHTS has just been absolutely wonderful to us and for the parade. And there's volunteers and people come out and mark streets at night, and everybody does their thing. And of course, Dwayne Hardy did so many things in the backside that we didn't even know that he did. So trying to replace him is taking 10 new volunteers.
Peeling away the onions layers of what really goes on with this event. I love that you were both nominated by the SCV 4th of July Parade Committee. And this is one of your tremendous loves. You give so much to it. But again, you want something done, ask a busy person. The two of you have really busy lives and show no signs of slowing down. And I always say that no matter what happens for the SCV Man and Woman of the Year event, you know, the old adage, oh, it's an honor just to be nominated.
It is.
I love that the two of you stand up in front of our community and show what true love of community is, and that you're working tirelessly and that you were nominated is a great honor. And I'm so glad that you show others what could possibly be done. After this event, after no signs of slowing, you're just going to keep at this, right?
Oh, yes.
I retired from teaching in June and was elected to the board in November. I'm also a full-time realtor and full-time grandma and an okay wife. And he's also my real estate partner. So we keep him busy there. And he's on the personnel commission for the William S. Hart High School District, among other things. And then Santa starts about November. And we do Santa for downtown
Newhall. I hope there are kids listening.
This is why they call it being retired, because you're tired all over again from everything you've put on your plate.
In just a different way.
It's
wonderful for me, especially because I miss teaching, and this keeps me very, very busy. And with grandchildren and my own kids, we do keep pretty busy.
The community is very lucky to have you both. And no matter, as I say, what happens for this 51st annual SCV Man and Woman of the Year, thank you for already being a Man and Woman of the Year and Mr. and Mrs. of the Year.
Yes.
Because you help keep Santa Clarita the wonderful community that it is. So congratulations to both of you on your nominations.